Hi guys, this is Lolu Fully Loaded, and you're watching the Haul Monitor on the HaulBlog channel. Vroom, vroom.
Thanks for checking out this episode of the Haul Monitor. Today we feature sharensBUZZED, LoLuFullyLoaded, and BentleyBlonde. Also as a bonus, later in the show, I'll have a conversation with MrZanderJaymz to determine once and for all if he's gay or straight. Also stick around at the end because we're having another contest to win a HaulBlog t-shirt. But first, let's get things started with sharensBUZZED. As I'm sure you can probably guess, I watch a buttload of beauty how-to videos all for the sake of this show. And as a guy, I gotta admit, most are pretty painful to sit through. But this one was a little different.
Hey guys, today I'm gonna show you how to look like the true high school girl. If you don't want to spend $50 on a bombshell bra, then just get a normal push-up bra. First off, you want to get a nice shirt that reveals the cleavage that you do not have. Now that you have a revealing shirt, make sure part of your bra shows.
Finally, a how-to video I can really throw my support behind.
So, if you really want to fulfill this look, you have to wear your normal shade of foundation. So, make sure it gets all powdery like that because, I mean, it's supposed to be powder, right? Chin. Nose. Forehead. Other forehead. I'm a prep, it's okay if I act dumb because it's cute, right?
Any guys out there have a problem with other forehead? Because I don't think it sounds dumb at all. I mean, sounds perfectly logical to me. And she's cute.
And if you miss a spot, sorry, my bad grammar. Too much cock in my mouth.
What? I mean, it's true. You tried talking with a mouthful of chicken.
You're a high school girl. You want everyone to know that you're great at making out. So, get your reddest lipstick. So it could be the greatest outline for your lips, your lip gloss. I'm sorry, bad grammar again. I don't pay attention in school. All I pay attention to is the teachers.
Did she say something? I wasn't paying attention. I always get tired after I eat chicken.
You guys are ready for the world. Thank you, and bye.
For those of you that have been watching the show since the beginning, you'll remember that back in episode 5, we featured MrZanderJaymz, one of only two guys we've ever had on the show. The thing is, after his segment was over, it was still kind of up in the air whether or not he's gay or straight. So I decided to invite him back on the show to burning question once and for all. Is he gay or is he straight? Hey, Xander, thanks for coming on the show.
No problem.
So everyone's dying to know, are you gay or are you straight?
Surprise, surprise. I'm gay.
I knew it. You know, after I watched your videos and then watched them some more and then dreamt about them and then watched them again, my gaydar was totally going off.
You do realize that only gay people have gaydars, right?
What are you talking about? I'm not gay.
Sure. Yeah. You're not gay.
No, seriously. I wake up every morning and repeat that to myself every day. I'm not gay. I'm not gay. I'm not gay. Well, I guess that takes care of that question. Xander's gay, and I am totally straight. Next up is Lolu Fully Loaded with this epic What's in My Bag haul.
This is my bag, and I'm actually doing this video because I just got this, and it's Tory Burch. It's really cute.
Oh my god, it is so cute.
Hand sanitizer from Ulta. I have like a huge one of these too. It's like this big.
I've heard that from girls before. Oh, who am I kidding? I'll be the first to admit that the Asian stereotype is true. We only buy small bottles of hand sanitizer.
Oh my god, I just squirted that all over my face.
Do you guys realize just how hard it is to keep the show PG? I mean, there are easily about a gazillion jokes right there.
This is what's it called? Swarovski crystal, and it goes from like black crystals to gray to silver.
She's like a hotter version of Thor. I mean, don't get me wrong, Thor is definitely hot. Like, if you guys haven't seen that movie yet, check it out. A+. When I first saw the title of this Bentley Blonde video, I thought to myself, yes, finally a Scheitze haul. Sadly, crap products has nothing to do with scented candles, toilet paper, or plungers.
Gives you just a really, in my opinion, dry and kicky face, and it just accentuates everything that I don't want accentuated. So this made my crap product list this month. My next product is a Mary Kay foundation.
Whoa, Mary Kay on a crap list? I gotta cut this one short. The last thing I need is hordes of Mary Kay ladies rolling up in their pink Cadillacs, knocking my door down, seeking revenge. Actually, maybe I do.
And so, yeah, this was definitely a no-go. Honestly, it took me so long to get rid of all the bumps on my face. My skin almost looked reptilian.
If reptilian, she is obviously a Tarsian. Nonetheless, O qua tangianwan, qua amsa lajiwan. You understand. Baba booey.
The aftertaste is almost like a carrot taste. But maybe if you dug your carrot out of the ground after a dog took a out of it. Do you know what I mean? It's that bad.
Based on that description, I assume it's got kind of a peanutty taste. I don't see the problem here.
The opening of the pigment bottle, it's kind of a small hole.
Small hole.
The hole is too narrow and the wand is too thick.
Thick wand.
They're stuck together. It's awful. What is that? It's a bug. Well, where'd he go?
I thought Hollywood. Where'd he go? Hollywood said, where'd who go?
Sorry, Hitches, for that kind of obscure reference there. For those of you that don't know, it's a quote from a classic 80s movie called Top Gun. You know, I've always been oddly fond of that movie. I loved it when Goose was on top. Or was it Maverick? It doesn't even matter. Well, that will do it for another episode of the Hall Monitor. Thanks for checking us out. Be sure to follow us on Facebook and Twitter. We've also got a voicemail, so give us a call and leave us a message letting us know who you'd like us to feature in a future episode, or just say hi. Last but not least, I promised that we'd be giving away a HaulBlog t-shirt, so here's how the contest works. First of all, just follow us on Facebook, take a picture of yourself expressing your love for HaulBlog like this one, and then post that picture right up on our Facebook wall. Apparently we're big in Papua New Guinea. We'll pick our favorite and then announce the winner next episode. See you later, bitch.